World Viral proudly presents Uncle Nasty's 10th annual Valentine's Day Mass Wedding at Red Rocks Saturday, February 14th at noon. We're back for our 10th year, and there isn't a cooler way to say I love you than getting married or renewing your vows at Red Rocks on Valentine's Day by a guy named Uncle Nasty. World Viral proudly presents Uncle Nasty's 10th annual Valentine's Day Mass Wedding at Red Rocks Saturday, February 14th at noon. We're back for our 10th year, and there isn't a cooler way to say I love you than getting married or renewing your vows at Red Rocks on Valentine's Day by a guy named Uncle Nasty. It's legal and binding. The 10th annual Uncle Nasty Valentine's Day Mass Wedding. Sign up today at worldviral.tv and we'll see you Valentine's Day on top of Red Rocks. What can I
say? What can I do? World Viral.
That sounds awesome.
Yes. Thanks.
Yeah.
You know?
For sure.
Like, what else do you say about that?
It's pretty cool.
You're looking to get hitched.
Stoked to have it.
3 weeks.
Dude.
With a bunch of people.
Yeah, with
together.
A bunch of people.
Uncle
Red
Nasty's
Rocks.
Been doing that for so long, too. And
yeah,
the
exactly.
amount of people that go out there and do that and have actually taken their first vows together under his, you know, deaconing or whatever he does, you want to call it, is amazing, dude. That's got to be a cool ass setting. I know when I interned with him, there was so many people that signed up to do that. It's so awesome. So
wild, I'm sure.
Yeah.
And now with Matt Need running around with some angel wings shooting you, that's like that's
deaconing,
amazing.
Is that the word?
I know he's been
deaconing.
I think you're a deacon, or else you're Buddha-ing. No.
Chad blows me away with like. She just surprises me all the time.
He's like, I have this buddy named Brandon, and he's notorious for inventing words. Like, every time when we go snowboarding, he'll invent, like, 5 new words.
Fishisms.
I think it's important to keep the vocabulary current and new, you know? I think new
updated.
Words are awesome.
I hate the word bae, though. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm not.
What word, Liz?
I can't stand it.
Yeah,
you just say babe.
No, it's B-A-E.
B-A-E.
Yeah.
Babe. That one.
Yeah, like
okay.
You take the B out of it, so then it's bae instead of bae.
And fleek? Fleek? What does fleek mean?
I haven't heard fleek.
Warm is
heard
weird.
One of
what's
words.
Yeah,
warm?
I've heard bae, dude. Bae
warm,
is just.
Warm like warm water? Warm. Warm.
That's warm?
Yeah, that's warm.
What?
I think though that like a lot of words
weird.
Can sound.
That sounds weird,
babe. You just say them in your head.
Definitely
weird. Or you're like driving in your car, just saying a word.
Yeah,
like,
over and over and over again. You're like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
this is weird.
Trip myself out doing that sometimes.
Well, Greg's texting Uncle Nasty, so
very cool.
I know we're going to be doing a call here shortly.
Yeah, we're going to get Uncle Nasty on the phone here shortly, but right now we're going to do our world famous. Motel Minute.
Yay.
Hashtag Motel Minute.
So last week on the Motel Minute, we witnessed the manager of the motel, Dave, punching the fuck out of this dude.
Dude, just knocked the fuck out of him, dude. Just,
it was his friend, right?
Oh, it was so awesome.
Yeah, they looked like they were great friends.
Yeah. Once he was on the ground, he's like, we're friends now, motherfucker. No.
So I wonder what's in store for us,
dude. I can only imagine. You never know what's going on.
The punch out part, I have it queued up too, just for anybody that missed
awesome.
Last week.
Yeah, everybody, if you missed last week's episode of Music Buzz Live Radio, it was probably the most epic Motel Minute we've had. We're pushing a good 15-20 Motel Minute.
Oh shit!
Yeah,
oh,
I was totally expecting that though. That's so awesome.
Just like, back and forth, blah. There it is.
Wow.
Damn. Look at that. Dude's on the ground.
He just beat the fuck out of that guy.
Here's the slow-mo.
For those of you that are sitting upstairs at Herman's Hideaway watching this, that happened about 30 feet from where you are right now.
Right. We can catch that all the time, but we have a new one.
So if you get really drunk, go over to the Red Pine. Just stagger on down, see what Dave has to say to you.
So
make some more entertaining footage.
For those new to our show, the Motel Minute is our weekly segment where we film the happenings at the motel next door. It's reality TV at its finest.
Because you never know what's going to happen in a Motel Minute.
And it's real. It's not staged.
Yeah, it's not staged at all.
It's really, really out.
Never know what the hell. I
love
Motel Minute.
Here's this week's Motel Minute.
This week's Motel Minute.
We want to take advantage of this area as the highest concentration of cannabis centers anywhere in the world. If you're looking for cannabis in Colorado, you should come to the Green Mile.
And a lot of them do.
The high tide raises all the boats. If we can get more people down here, it's not only good for the cannabis stores, it's good for the antique stores, it's good for the bars and restaurants, it's good for the roller derby store. It's good for everyone.
Evergreen Apothecary.
Oh, wait, it was me.
Was it?
Hi, I'm on my rag.
You're on the rag? That's rad.
In a motel minute, everything can change in a motel minute. The crackhead seems so strange in a motel minute. Everything can change.
My son's got a special request for you. My son's got a special request for you.
Yeah,
he's right.
Danielle has like merchandise mart over here.
Yeah.
She's got like watches, iPads, tablets.
Bangles.
No kidding. This is all from Motel residents.
People that
cheese.
Get arrested. Don't help. You get behind.
You guys moving this or what? You guys are on Craigslist?
This is nothing. This is nothing, man.
Seven laptops?
There's a voice changer.
Voice changer?
Yeah. I'm sorry, just like David.
Hello.
She wants to do it.
Say what's up? The top five people banned from the motel.
The top five people that are banned from the motel.
And we're going to add five more probably every day.
Okay.
Okay. So the first one is Richard Smoot.
Richard Smoot is banned.
AKA Red.
AKA Red.
And Danielle Douglas.
Okay.
Some of these are, you know, been banned for a long time. Lisa Kellers and family, also known as Lisa Moore. And Belladonna Gerbitz.
Banned, Belladonna.
Is that five? One more.
And the last banned person at the Red Pine Motel.
Gerald Andrews, in other words known as Andy.
They all have AKAs.
That's right, Becky and Andy.
All right.
So.
Don't come around here.
Right.
No mo.
We will give you five more. See all these?
Stay tuned. Five more.
That's right.
On the next Motel Minute.
That's right.
Ta-da!
So awesome.
So every week now we're going to get five people that are banned.
That's the plan. Hey, we have you guys, everybody upstairs are watching you from behind you. Lift your hands up if you enjoyed the Motel Minute.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
thank you so much.
Yeah.
That's what we're talking about.
Thank you guys for braving the snow and coming out tonight. I know I'm super pumped to see Lee Young and the Rex new songs. I don't know about y'all, but
very much so. Hell yeah. That sounds like a great time.
Yes.
And it's really snowy and crappy out, too, so they did really make it.
Yeah. It's beautiful outside. I love the snow.
Me too.
Yeah,
I'm going to Breck tomorrow. So.
Yeah. Are you really?
I love it.
Cool.
Oh, nice. Yeah. Safe travels.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Liz is not stoked on the roads. And she told me that.
She slides around, it sounds like.
I did on the way here. It was
good times.
Really scary.
What kind of car are you driving?
A Toyota Corolla.
It
has brand new tires on it.
That's safe.
Yeah, but still, I'm not good with that.
My car still slides a little bit. I have four-wheel drive, so.
You got a four-wheel drive? What do you drive?
Yeah, Jeep Liberty 4x4 and an FJ Cruiser, so...
Cool.
And FJ Cruiser. She's like, I got both of them.
Nice. She's like, in my three-car garage.
That was like the dude car, though.
Hell yeah.
I'm glad I'm not driving my Ford E350 Econoline XL van.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's
right?
A beast now.
It's like a bowling ball going down a hill.
It's like a bowling ball. Yeah, going down a hill.
Yeah, pretty much. But this carpet that's on the ground, we moved that whole carpet in your van.
Yeah. It's
pretty
cool. I've moved a lot of random shit in that van.
Yeah.
Forever van.
Yeah.
I'm not very excited about driving in the ice either.
All right, so now we're going to do our world-famous Hack It or Axe It segment.
Yay!
Where we play submitted songs from local artists and decide if they are playlist appropriate for our program. It is it's an interesting feature because there are a lot of bands that are really good that are not playlist appropriate for Music Buzz Live Radio.
It's true. We have had some.
But... we have a lot of good talent. All the songs you hear on our show
made it through our gauntlet.
Made it through, most of them.
So we're gonna maybe we can get the people upstairs to help us out.
Yeah,
that might be fun.
Let's see if they would want to help out.
Yeah.
All right.
Aww.
Let's start. Let's get this thing going, man.
It's pretty groovy.
Yeah, I like that little hook part.
Grooving.
Exactly.
Get a moose. Show us how a moose dance.
That's my only dance.
The moose dance. I don't know what that was.
One of these days we'll show the video of me dancing in Paris when I was hammered drunk.
That'd be badass.
Oh, so exciting.
Did you ever go to the Buddha bar?
The Buddha bar?
Yeah, it's shaped like a Buddha.
No, I
didn't. And they got a big old, they got a Buddha inside it.
Wow.
Yeah, it's cool.
I
saw the French president there when
that's
I went.
It.
Yeah.
Cool. That's awesome.
It was pretty
very
cool.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think there were any political leaders where I was. But.
Yeah. So I'm not usually the one straight out of the gates to be like, I like this song, but I do like it.
Yeah,
it's
I do
cool.
like
it.
I think we're going to hack this one.
Pretty cool.
Got me from the beginning.
All right, everybody upstairs, if you like it, raise your hand. You think we should hack it?
Oh, we got a couple. There's
a
couple.
There's a couple. Cool, thank you.
There's another one. Hey yo.
Thanks
so,
for playing.
Yeah, so it looks like upstairs likes it. Dude.
I like it.
I think it's got a good feel. It's got that Jethro Tull-ish.
I think it's
newer.
Radio appropriate.
Yeah.
You know, the feel like.
How about Jaime? Hey
Jaime
and Joe, do you like this song?
Do you guys like that, you think? What do you think, Joe?
They're leaving the camera.
They just walk away.
Yeah. I think I hear him. Hey yo. Jaime seemed pretty excited about it. I think Jaime would blare this in his hoopty rolling in.
Little did we know that that's actually Jaime's band.
Yeah.
Is it?
So we're definitely hacking that one. That one makes it through the gauntlet, I think.
Let's hack that one.
All right, here's another one. Danny doesn't want to play. Danny doesn't want to play dumb anymore. Danny doesn't want to be. Danny doesn't want to be. Purple-eyed boar. You think I wouldn't know that you're a spy on me? You think I couldn't tell Dario from season 2 to season 3? Danny doesn't want to kill.
She sounds like the singer of
Danny
that play
wanna
Wicked,
kill
that children musical play.
I don't know if anyone... Danny wants to free the slaves. But I will tell you that this band Danny is a Game of Thrones themed punk band.
Is that right?
Yeah.
That's kind of specific.
These guys are playing here this weekend, huh?
Yeah, they're playing here this weekend.
I've liked it so far.
I'm not gonna like it just because they're playing here this weekend.
It's not biased. I like this part. It's like, it's fun.
I think we'll axe this one.
Yeah?
And we'll give him a shot with another song.
Well, I was thinking B-listed, because we could B-list? Put this to a segment, you know, like maybe a Motel Minute background music, you know?
What do you think about upstairs? What do you think upstairs thinks?
Upstairs? Raise your hand if you like it. No, there's one. Two people like it. Three.
I think they're just trying to... they're just trying to find themselves on the screen right now. You know what I mean? I don't really think that they're like, this song is cool. They're like, here I am, right here.
I think you should give it a little credit. It's fun. All right, so we decided.
I'd B-listed.
It's
dude.
B-listed.
Yeah, B-listed. All right,
here's another one. Negativity in this world. To let it bring you down. Right, let's go to a place where we can be free. Where you hate out of the gate.
That's personal interest. What do you see? You can do
anything. Keep your head high. I don't know. I like it.
It's trying to grow on me. I didn't initially like it either. It's trying to. It's
all up to you. Now that it sounds more like, you know, stick figure and stuff, as opposed to.
Did you say stick figure?
Yeah, stick figure.
Do you mean like simple?
Oh, the band.
Is that what you mean? Yeah. Like stick figure-y?
No, the band.
Oh, my bad.
No, they're like a reggae-ish band.
Right over the head.
Yeah,
dude.
No,
wait, what?
They're awesome. They're awesome. But the beginning sounded like simple. A boy singing a love song to a girl.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so what's the verdict?
Y'all know my opinion.
Moose?
What do you think, Liz?
I like the background music to it.
Yeah.
So is do you think it's what, B-listed?
Sorry, dude. No,
that's not a rating review.
I think I'd probably axe it only because I don't really think that it's appropriate for the station. Like,
no.
I don't think so. I just don't know if I would want to listen to more of it. You know what I mean? I don't know. I can be wrong.
All right.
Should we ask the upstairs one more time?
Let's ask upstairs if they want to axe it this time.
So if you like it, if you want to get rid of it, raise your hand.
There you go. That's right.
Yeah, that's a good one.
If you want to get rid of it, raise your hand.
They all love it.
They all love it.
Well, there's a couple folks in the corner that are with me.
Thanks for playing.
We see you.
Appreciated.
All right, so
I think the majority liked it upstairs. It sounds like, right?
Well, let's move on to the next one.
All right.
That was a definite uncertain.
Baby. You have the light.
Yeah, I guess you know who it is now.
I got some nice scratches on there. Like,
we already played this song. Hold on.
Hey, I'm from Denver. Hey, y'all, I'm from Denver.
I say hack it already, please.
I like it. I can rap, has like random noises and just all dark rap.
Yeah, I can hang with it. I think all he has to do is say John Elway, and I'm like a big fan because he already said Colorado and weed, so
right.
That's got my heart.
What about Todd Helton?
Todd Helton?
Todd Helton doesn't have my heart.
I don't know if he says any.
Well, he's retired. So
mentions
he doesn't have it by now. I don't baseball. Think he's ever going to get it. They buy a pound each, and so they may just sell. Cause everybody's trying to get half baked from Dro Smoke like Dave Chappelle. I see them blazing hits, and on a side note, I'm trying to see if I could date Taylor Swift. I like a pretty lush lips, plus a hips and tush.
Well, let's get back
to the house.
I've loved her
since I
was a kid.
Taylor Swift
seems like
no. I don't really care for Taylor Swift so much.
You don't think she's hot? You don't think Avril Lavigne's hot?
Oh, she's Canadian. She's all right. She's cool with me. I don't mind. But Taylor Swift,
Canadian.
I don't really listen to her music.
Clearly,
She's pretty, but I don't listen to her music.
Yeah, I'm in the same boat. Yeah,
so, what do you guys think about this? You obviously know who it is, right?
I like it.
This anxious
notes, though, like in the background, are throwing me off though.
There's what?
Those notes in the background of it, they're just. The off-key ones?
The keys?
Yeah, it throws me off just a little bit. Because I think someone's playing something in the other room.
I'm waiting for...
That's the sound check upstairs.
Not that bass.
Okay.
No. No, like if you turn it up, you'll hear it.
I'm waiting for him to say there ain't no such thing as halfway crooks, dude. You know, that's where I'm getting that beat from.
Do you want to hear another song?
Yes.
Yeah?
Okay. Are we hacking that one?
I want to listen to this, the whole record, I think, because I'm a fan of Anxious. I want to be fair, you know. I just put the CD in there. I think maybe next week we'll bring, like, a few specific hits if we don't find something in here.
Yeah, I think we can find a better song.
Yeah. Damn, son, where'd you find this? Okay, first off, I'm a motherfucking
killer when it comes to the
beats I'm split.
Guess this genius shit is in my jeans like some Levi stitches. And indeed I'm different. Reppin' Denver till the day I'm incapable of remembering what the
fuck I'm
saying.
But it's only that day I will do it big like a person. MGK.
What do you think, Moose?
I'd put it on the B-list.
B-list? Yeah. I'm glad that we have high standards on Music Buzz Live Radio.
Yeah, very much so.
I mean, yeah, I think you'd have to, right? A little bit.
Can't let everybody in.
Yeah.
Is that it?
We got one more.
One more song.
I did like the second one a little bit better than the first one, I think. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Is this the same guy?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay, I like this one better.
I like the first one.
Did you?
Mm. I like the second one too, but...
Whoa.
That's how I feel.
Well, you're like super high in the back of the car. Yeah.
I like it, I don't know. I like it so far.
Mm-hmm.
Wait till I hear the vocals.
Yeah.
Vocals and words.
I know the road less traveled is a narrow path, and I know that there is no turning back. I know the truth will unravel the impending wrath. I wanna know that you are with me when the
That's
sky
cool. I was actually expecting a female singer. But
what's that?
I was actually expecting a female singer for some reason.
Yeah.
I feel like I was kind of getting to the point where I was expecting there to not even be any words.
Right.
Yeah.
But I liked it.
Yeah.
Once it
finally got
there.
I think that the voice and the background music definitely matched well. I think he was making it sound good.
Mm-hmm. Wait, it's not a chick?
Wait, what? No. Chick could sing it though.
What do you think, Johnny? Do you like this song so far? No? He's not. My buddy that came down to check out the show.
Hiding in the dark.
He's hiding in the dark over there. He didn't really enjoy this one that much. Yeah.
What about Upstairs? You guys paying attention? Did you like that song?
Anyone?
Are you guys
sound checking?
You guys,
I don't think they can hear us anymore.
Right, well, that was
get your beers at the bar. Okay. There you go. Right?
Well, that was fun.
That was tonight's Hackular Accent.
Yes.
Hashtag.
I liked it.
That was fun.
Hell yeah.
I feel like we were really harsh tonight.
I think we were a little bit harsh.
We only like full on hack one song.
No, we did two, right?
Two, and we got like a whole audience upstairs.
Yeah.
Like, damn, these guys are dicks.
Right? We are dicks.
You know, you got to catch us on the other nights, because if I smoke the sativa first, then typically I'm usually hacking away.
Yeah, some nights you just hack everybody.
I love everyone's music, man. Dude, like,
I want some sativa right now. That's making me love it all.
For that.
So, Greg Stone, let's see.
How's he doing?
I missed his call earlier, so let's get that going.
Let's get that going.
Yeah, let's get Uncle Nasty on the
I'd
phone.
I'd love to talk to him.
Uncle Nasty.
Hail.
Hail Nasty.
Straight up hail. Hell yeah.
Hey,
what's up, man? How you doing, Nasty?
I'm good. What's going on?
We're chilling here. This is the tail end of our weekly show, Music Buzz Live Radio. We're all hanging out here. Look, glancing at my phone, we just finished our Hack It or Exit segment. We did play the ad for your mass wedding, but we figured we'd talk to you real quick. How are you?
Well, let's do both.
All right.
Talk to me, then you can play the ad later.
Well, yeah, we'll do the ad again later. Let's get the lowdown on the ceremony itself, man. What are all the details?
Did you hear that?
I did not.
It's a control room. We want to know the details about the ceremony itself. If you could just break it down for us.
All right, well, we've got registration going on at worldviral.tv. You can sign up, didn't cost you anything. We just need to get a head count, leave your email and phone number, so there's also communication in case there's some sort of weather cancellation or postponement. So just do that so we know who's coming. It doesn't cost you a dime. You can get married. It's legit. I'm an ordained minister in the Church of World Peace. You can also renew your vows. It's non-discriminatory. We're not there to judge anybody. So if you want to come up there and enjoy the beautiful, beautiful backdrop of Red Rocks on Valentine's Day, feel free. Sign up. Let's get you out there. It's going to be a good time.
What a cool thing, man.
Yeah.
It's the 10th annual.
10th annual. So a lot of people... Yep. Have been wedded by the ordained
minister. That's what I was trying to figure out, deacon style.
Yeah,
when I was
saying, crazy.
That's pretty cool, man.
Straight up ordained.
And everybody's chiming in, so we're gonna have this archived, and we'll be able to share it later, man. That's a good reaction from everybody in the studio.
Hail, by the
way. Thanks for the play-by-play, Chris Thomas.
Absolutely,
man. That's what Chris Thomas is good for.
Play-by-play. And we love
it. What happened to the Skype?
I didn't figure it out in time, and this has been a busy week, having lost a friend, so I haven't really messed with Trevor too much, you know. But he's got the Skype's all hooked up on the computer, the producer computer. We got he's got the Skype account.
Who did we lose?
Steph Bailey. Steph Bailey.
She,
you know Steph, right?
Yeah, that's awful. What happened?
She had a surgery that shouldn't have gone. Surgeries are risky to begin with, but she had a surgery and then an embolism following that, and it took everybody by surprise. You know, she was dealing with it like a champ, and the last time she was here, you know, she told a couple people that she was in pain. The new year, you know, she's just kind of laying low, and then the news kind of shook us all. So
yeah,
my condolences to her family and friends. That's awful.
Yeah. So, I mean, we got everybody's, the grieving.
Getting geared up for this big Valentine's Day event. It's going to be a blast. I want to thank World Viral for jumping on board and helping me out this year. It's great because I didn't have a media partner, and there was a lot of interest in this going down. So I appreciate you jumping on board, CT. Of course, our boy, when he's not busy beating people's ass.
Trevor. Yeah.
Trevor for throwing down some sponsorship as well. So I'm excited to do this. And like I said, it doesn't cost a dime. You can bring your, it's family friendly. I know CT's working on some top notch entertainment.
That's right.
And so we'll probably start gathering, right around 11 o'clock, and then the service will commence at noon. If you are planning on getting married, you do have to have a marriage license. If you're just renewing your vows, just register at worldviral.tv, right? It's all self-explanatory once you get to the website. So
should be a lot of fun, man.
Hey,
Uncle Nasty.
Ask him.
Hold on one sec.
Do you have any idea how many couples you've wed over the last 10 years?
Moose wants to know.
Oh,
did you hear
thousands.
That?
Thousands.
Oh, he can hear us now.
Wow.
Hey, yo.
Barely.
That's a lot.
Thousands and thousands of couples.
That's
so
cool.
That's wild, yeah.
I know the times that I've been anywhere around the Uncle Nasty mass wedding, it has been awesome. I know that every couple that has gone up there has completely enjoyed being wed by Uncle Nasty. I mean, he's a Denver icon, you know what I mean? And to be able to be up at Red Rocks where it's all beautiful.
And everybody's already in a good mood because they're getting married. So
for sure.
It's going to be a good time.
Good vibes all around. Good energy, I bet.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely.
The nature, everything.
We really appreciate you letting World Viral be a part of that, because I know that it's definitely something that your fans that follow you have always come to love, and to know that you're able to carry on the 10 years, the tradition going is really big for everybody in Denver, Uncle Nasty.
Did you hear that?
Well, I appreciate, the listenership that I've received from this community over the last 20, 30 years, man. It's been great, and it's the least I can do. You know, it's a lot of fun. People look forward to it, and it doesn't take a whole lot of time out of your day, and it's really nice, and you'll probably get laid.
All right.
That's awesome.
You better get laid. You just got married.
Maybe
right?
That'll take more time out of your day.
Well, that's a good note to end on. I want to play your ad real quick so we can scrunch this all together, man. Thanks for calling in, Greg.
Yeah, thanks for joining us, Nasty.
Hey, no problem.
Hail, hail, hail.
We have some sort of reception at Herman's, aren't we? There's more stuff we're rolling out, so keep checking the website once you've registered. How's that sound?
There you go. We want to get you in studio next week if possible. We'll find some time. But that's Uncle Nasty that you're hearing on the phone. Thanks again, my brother.
Hail Nasty.
Mass wedding.
Hail Nasty.
You know, I thank you guys. Thanks for partnering up. I appreciate it. Thanks, everybody in the studio. And I'll come in next time. Thanks for having me, CT.
You bet, brother. And here's the ad.
World Viral proudly presents Uncle Nasty's 10th annual Valentine's Day Mass Wedding at Red Rocks Saturday, February 14th at noon. We're back for our 10th year, and there isn't a cooler way to say I love you than getting married or renewing your vows at Red Rocks on Valentine's Day by a guy named Uncle Nasty. It's legal and binding. The 10th annual Uncle Nasty Valentine's Day Mass Wedding. Sign up today at worldviral.tv, and we'll see you Valentine's Day on top of Red Rocks.
What can I say? What can I do? What exactly was it that Matt Need was shooting there? Was that a rose or was it a dart?
It was one of those sticky bow and arrow
rubber ended.
Okay. Yeah, rubber ended.
Yeah,
so he's supposed to be like a Cupid.
He is, dude. Matt Need in a Cupid outfit with a little wing shooting shit. That's got to be worth going up there for.
Dude, unfortunately, or for better or for worse, for lack of a better term, too. That's what I visualize when I think about the mass wedding is Matt Need's, you know, no need to be naked ass like running around in a tutu.
Is that actually how it goes down?
For better or for worse,
been known to run around. Yep, for sure, definitely.
That's funny.
So, and Nasty does a really good thing. Him doing that as long as he has been, to be able to be married up at Red Rocks is original anyway. There's only so many times in your life that you're going to be able to be up at Red Rocks anyway. But it's so. They do a really good thing up there. So.
I thought you were going to say there's only so many times in your life that you're going to get married.
Or married, I suppose. You never know if you could get laid at Red Rocks, too, if you find that.
I bet people have sex at Red Rocks all the time.
All the time.
Oh, yeah. I had sex at Red Rocks, but it wasn't actually in the theater. It was just like outside on a rock.
Yeah.
On a Red Rock.
That's so cool.
I've had sex at Red Rocks, too, man.
Nice. I'm a virgin.
CT has never had sex at Red Rocks.
We'll find that right girl for you, man.
Thanks.
Yeah, we're still working on breaking down that barrier.
It's been a hell of a show, man. It's 8 o'clock exactly.
Is it?
Oh, wow, man. It flies by. It always flies by.
It does.
Hey, do you mind, since we talked about Steph Bailey, I have a video queued up of Steph interviewing Boy Hits Car.
Of course.
Yeah. Is that cool?
That'd be awesome.
Go out with that?
I think we should, man.
All right, well, let's say a warm goodbye from everyone here at World Viral. Thank you guys for joining our show tonight. Everything will be cataloged at worldviral.tv in the Music Buzz Live Radio Archives. You can share the hell out of it.
And come by Evergreen Apothecary this weekend also. We do have 30% off of all edibles. So go in and say World Viral gets you 10% off also, but all of the edibles are 30% off. So drop by and say what's up to our sponsor.
All 10% right. off. Or go say World Viral at Evergreen Apothecary.
We'll see you next week.
Next week.
World Viral.
We moved out the boxes, drywalled, painted, moved in all the decor that you see around you, and now it looks like a porn set.
Hell yeah.
From me and on behalf of all the people at Herman's, you know, we're stoked to have you guys here.
Yeah, we're very stoked to be back. You guys have always been really good to us. So,
and Steph's a huge fan, man.
Yeah, Steph's got our back. She feeds us and books us shows.
She's been doing a lot of cool stuff here at Herman's. She's a good friend of mine, so we're happy to have her. Right. You want to say anything, Steph?
I was wondering if Craig here could talk a little bit about his stage dive.
Oh,
I knew it was a good idea to get you on the show.
Well, what would you like to know?
What was going through your mind?
Not climbing up there and jumping. That wasn't going through my mind. But once I got stuck up there, I really had no choice.
And
there was 8,000 people chanting jump, so what are you going to do? I guess I never knew an exact height. Somebody posted that it was like 60-something feet, like 68 feet,
I guess. Are you kidding me?
That's what the radio station said, because they hung banners, and they, after I got back from the ER, they're like, You know where the, it's called K-Rock, and they said where the R is in the banner up there, we know exactly how high that is, and it's right level with the speaker you jumped off. That's 68 sick, feet. So they posted that video and put that that height. I know it was high enough to still be falling and have time to think.
Wow.
Like falling and going, wow, I'm still falling.
So how long were you in the ER?
Not that long. I spit up a little bit blood, so the EMTs were like, you should go get x-rayed. So I was like, okay, fine, I'll go. I didn't really want to because I went and got x-rayed and missed Cake. That was the one band I wanted to see was Cake.
Yeah, I met the bass really player bummed. From Cake. I'm a bass player guy. I'm friends with all the bass players, man. I don't know how that is.
Nice.
But you missed Cake because of the
ER
experience?
I missed Cake because I had to go get x-rayed, and I was so bummed. It was like the one band I wanted to see on that festival. But I checked out okay, though, and then I literally went back, drank the rest of the night, and didn't sleep. And
that's so hardcore.
Yeah.
There you go. That's the real rock and roll.
That's rock and roll.
I remember we're friends with Sid Wilson from Slipknot. He's performed here a couple times, and I remember he does a lot of stage antics, and they had they wheeled people onto the stage that hurt themselves from doing some stage diving. So that's just part of the deal, you know. If you're gonna share that moment with the audience, you know, what, there's not a better way than just jump into them, right?
Absolutely. As long as they know you're coming.
Well, with 60 feet and you still being alive, I would venture to say that they were ready for you.
They were ready.
Did anybody else go to the ER with you?
No, but we did get some messages that there was a couple minor injuries, but everybody was happy that they basically saved my life.
Boy Hits Car fans, you guys are cool as fuck, man. If you're in Denver tonight, you need to come to Herman's Hideaway, see Boy Hits Car tonight on the stage here, and hang out with Steph Bailey, too. She's here. She's my buddy.
Steph
Bailey. You want to throw any love out to anybody that's going to be watching? We're going to have this archived in on the website, and you can...
We just want to give all our appreciation to the Worldwide Love Corps Alliance and music fans everywhere.
Bam.
Boom. Keep supporting live independent music.
Will you guys do me a favor and say, hey, this is Boy Hits Car. You're watching worldviral.tv so I can edit that into other things later?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, this is Craig from Boy Hits Car.
This is Eric.
And this is Bill. And you're watching worldviral.tv.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Yeah, yeah.
Word.
Have a good night. Here's some Boy Hits Car on the way out.
Thanks, Chris.
Fuck yeah.
Thanks a lot, Chris.
Herman's Hideaway, on the corner of Iowa and Broadway. Your favorite independent anti-corporate venue, featuring Westward's best patio. Now serving award-winning food. From metal to jazz to hip-hop, Herman's Hideaway has something for everyone. And if you want to book your act at Herman's Hideaway, email booking@hermanshideaway.com or call 303-777-2535. There's only one venue, family owned and operated for over 50 years. Holding it down in Denver. Go to hermanshideaway.com for more information and show listings.